the United States, when you're asked where you're from, it's usually in reference to where you're born. In Ghana, when you're asked where you're from, it's more about your ancestral lineage, where you find your roots. So I was born in Germany, but I was born to Guinean parents. I've lived all my life in Ghana, and I find home in Ghana. In Ghana, I am an Ashanti woman. The Ashanti kingdom is located in the central part of Ghana. It's right in the heart of Ghana. But I grew up in both Accra, which is the capital, and Kumasi, which is the Accra is the capital of the country, but Kumasi is the capital of Ashanti kingdom. And so I moved between these metropolitan cities. Well, I find my inspiration from the Ashanti kingdom, where I'm from. And there, it's almost like art becomes this thing in motion. It's always changing and always extending the culture. And I would see my dad dress up in these artistic garments or go to Durbers where people are dancing in these elaborate dresses or holding staffs, and it almost seems like art was an extension of oneself in that culture. But also the functionality of art, the embodiment of art, is something that I found to be at the root of Ashanti artistic practices. And so I borrow a lot of what I do from that culture. St. Louis is a promising city. I mean, it's a city at its tipping point. And as an artist, it's important for me to feel like I'm making a mark or I'm leaving my fingerprints on the landscape of St. Louis. As much as it is very promising and it's full of energy and full of opportunity, it's also a city that's really challenged. It's challenged physically, it's challenged sociopolitically, it's challenged culturally. And as an artist, I take the context of St. Louis, and that inspires my work. A lot of my work addresses issues of colorism, complexion politics, the politics of dress, and these are things that are at the core of St. Louis. And so it gives me that relevance to create and to see that, you know, art can make a positive change or a positive impact in the city. As an artist, as a transmedial artist, my work is always about its concept. What is it trying to say? What am I trying to enunciate with my art? And I think that the medium comes later on in my creative process. But I've always tried to, and more recently, try to find ways of marrying this world of fashion with the world of art. And my use of textiles is becoming more potent, especially in this exhibition. I see clothing as, again, the embodiment of art, that the fact that it's attached to your body is something that is sensual, but also something that's very personal. I started conceptualizing the project in August 2016, and I was struck by how disconnected I felt to the park. And it was about the investment of researching, you know, the history of the park, the works that exist in it. And I was really interested in finding ways to insert myself in the park. So speaking of, you know, what's familiar and unfamiliar, it was really about making things that are unfamiliar to me seem so familiar. And I, for example, if you look at the eyeball, the famous iconic eyeball, I started to look at it as a circle that can be used in the language of textiles. And so a lot of these designs were looking at the works as basic shapes. So you can talk about this idea of fragmenting the works to find my place or myself in it. And I also took inspiration from West African textiles. So you would see a jot being infused with a liberman in one piece. And then in the next piece, you would see another work being infused with another. And the outburst of color to kind of, in a way, reference West African textiles and textiles that I use on a day-to-day back home in Ghana. And the idea of foreign and native is also interesting because as I was visiting the park and getting a sense of what Lohmeyer is, a culture that's here, I also noticed that it being an outdoor museum, an outdoor park, there were things, there were plants that were foreign to the park, that were growing, and there were other materials that were not. And it was interesting to see nature take its course in the midst of these monumental sculptures. And so that also eased into my work, seeing it in season, from rainy season to snow, and seeing the works in different perspectives.